Hello everyone, this is a tutorial about how we can install Red Hat Linux in our VirtualBox. So okay, for this we must have a system, and in system we must install a VirtualBox machine. Okay, here it is, VirtualBox. You can see this icon, and this is the lookup, this is the display of VirtualBox. Here I have installed 5 machine in my VirtualBox. So now here I will tell you that how we can install a new machine in the VirtualBox. So for this, as you can see here, I have already installed some machine, so I am going to show you the new installation. Okay, if you have a new you are new to use VirtualBox, then you will see the blank screen here, and you will see the same type of this type of screen on your VirtualBox. So here you have to click, you have to just press this new option, and next to this you have to give the name. Okay, then a name of the operating system that you want to install. Here I am just here I am writing Linux. Okay, only Linux. And here the type that is already Linux, and here the version, which version you want to run. Here I am running the Red Hat version. Okay, and here you can see below Red Hat, and here it is 2-bit version. First is 32 and 60 is 64. You can choose of your choice. Next, no, it's saying that the name is already running, so you can't name the duplicate name. Okay, so here I will change the name Red Hat, Linux Red. Okay, next, let me see, there is no name like this. So Red Linux Red. Okay, next, click to next, and here you have to give the RAM size. Okay, up to this screen level you can give the maximum RAM to this operating system. So here I am giving you 2048. Okay, this is my RAM. Next, click next option. And just click next, and here just click next. You don't need to make any changes in this, just remain the default. Here dynamic allocated, click next. And here you can give the space accordingly. Here I am giving 16 GB, that will be enough for this installation. If you want to give more, you can give according to as if you have more space in your disk. Now click on the next option. Now the we have created VirtualBox. Okay, now we have made some couple of changes in the settings. So we select this and click to the setting option, and here new pop-up window comes on the screen, and just come to the system. Okay, here we will uncheck the floppy, because floppy are not used in these days, we are using hard disk. Okay, so just press click on the hard disk and up the hard disk. Okay, next to this we will come to the storage. Here just select this empty. Okay, here we have to provide the path. As you know, if you want to install any operating system, you must have the ISO file. So here we also need a ISO file of Linux. Okay, Red Hat Linux. So here I have Red Hat Linux ISO file that is kept in my G drive. You have to provide the path of this ISO file. So this is my this is, okay, RHEL54ISO. This is my Red Hat file, that is version 5. And next to this we have to make settings of network. Here sorry. Here we have to choose a bridge adapter. Why we are choosing bridge adapter? Because bridge adapter works as a bridge between host machine and the virtual machine. So now all have done. Now just press OK. Next to this we have to just start. Okay, just press the start option, and you will see that a new screen that your virtual machine will be open. If you will maximize this, you will see a minimized screen of this machine. So for this you have to come, if you want to maximize this, you have to come view option and just press scaled or scaled mode. Okay, or you can directly press host plus C, then it will comes maximize, it will be minimized, and we have to again it maximize. Yeah, now you can see it is on the full mode. Okay, now for installation we have 2 modes of Red Hat Linux. Here first we have graphical mode, and second you can see that is text mode. If you want to install graphical mode, then just hit directly enter. And if you want to install text mode, then we have to type here Linux text, okay, and hit enter. Hit enter. Now I am going to install just graphical mode. So I am just pressing, I am just hitting enter. Okay, now you can see the installation process has been started. In the coming time we have made some couple of changes during the installation. Just waiting. Okay, it can take 10 to 15 minutes, depend on your speed of your system. Here it is asking for the CD. As you know, we are creating it on the virtual virtual system, so we do not have any physical disk. So here we will press this option. Okay, now it is again running. So let's just wait for a few seconds. It is gonna do. Yes, it is running. So if you are installing it first time, so you have to be careful, very careful, because if you will made any single mistake, then it will not be considered as a good installation. Okay, you can your installation can be wrong installation. Okay, here now you can see that it has come on a new screen. Now here we will press just Alt N, don't need to do anything. Here the installation language, I am choosing it English, and you can choose accordingly. And here is keyboard language, that is US English. Okay, and Alt N for next. Now it is asking for the installation number. As I told you, we do not have any physical disk, so we will skip this step as well. And press Alt O, okay. And just okay, Alt S for skip. Enter. Now it is asking that we would you like to initialize this drive erase all data? Yes, we will delete all data because we do not have any data on this, and we are creating a virtual machine here. Now we do have a new screen on your screen. Just look at this, okay? Here what we need to do, this is screen for the creating a new partition, okay? Just let me select this. Here we have four options. First, that defines us that to remove. Okay, now look on the screen. Remove all partition on selected drive and create a default layout. If you have more than one partition, then you can choose this option and create a default layout. Next says about remove Linux partition and selected drive and create default layout. It is asking that if you already have Linux partition, it will create only that line, particular Linux partition. Now next is use free space and select a drive and create default layout. It is asking that if you have a free space, it can be installed in that particular space. But here we can create a custom layout because we do not have above situations. Here we will create a layout and just hit the next option. And here we have the 16 GB space. Okay, you can see free and free space and the MB 16384 MB we have space. Now what we have to do, we have to create a new partition for this. Okay, just click Alt, click on new or type Alt W. Here we have to provide a mount point. Okay, what type of mount point? Here mount point is a place where it installs. Okay, so here I will type slash. Okay, at slash we mount this virtual machine. Next tab, it will be same, and here we can give the space. Okay, you can keep some space for the future use, as I have provided 16 GB storage to this. So now I am providing just 14 GB space for the mount. Okay, now press Alt O, and we have create a new partition as well for boot. Okay, slash boot, and remain the same, and the 100 MB will be enough here size. Just press okay and next. As you can see, one is the boot mount point is boot, and second is for the storage. Okay, there is a more option, like you can see that or LVM in the right middle. So these are the, I will tell about these options in the my next videos. So now it is okay for now. Okay, just you have to do till up to here. Now press Alt N, and it is again asking you haven't created a swap partition. Swap partition is a virtual memory. Okay, we are not creating here virtual memory like RAM, or you can do something more here. I will tell about this in the next video. So just press hit yes option, and again you don't need to make any changes here. Just Alt N, again Alt N, and here we have to select the region. Okay, time region. So here just tab, and here I will select the Kolkata as it is. Here it is, no. Okay, Asia Kolkata, here it is. Okay, and my region is Asia Kolkata, so you can choose accordingly. Now again click Alt N, and here we have to give the root user password. Okay, here the minimum character required is 6. Okay, so I am giving here password next 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, and press next. Now it can take some time to install this installation. Again, just you don't need to make any changes here, as what I am doing you just going on. Okay, if you are an advanced user, then you can think to make any changes, but if you are a beginner, you don't need to make any changes here. You have to just follow my steps step by step. Okay, if you will make any changes in the installation process, or you will do any effort with yourself, then there may be something wrong with your installation, or it might not be working. Okay, so be careful while making any changes, extra changes, as I didn't told in the previous. So okay, now the installation process has started. The changes that we have to make, we already had made in the previous time. Okay, now we have to wait for a few times that for the time it will install. It can take up to 5 to 7 minutes. Okay, so we have to wait. It depends on your system that how much time it takes. as you can see on my screen that it is just near to complete the installation. It can take more time on your system, depends on the speed or processor of your system. Now you can see it is just near to install. After this process will be completed, it will be asking for the reboot your system. Okay, for we have to then we have to get the permission of the reboot. So let's wait for the completion of this. Okay, it is asking for the here you can see the reboot, okay, in the right bottom. So now we press this reboot option or type alt t. Okay, now it is rebooting my system. So just wait for the reboot. Okay, it will be restart itself. You don't need to make any changes or you don't need to do anything. As you can see on my screen, it is getting, it is rebooting. You have to be careful, you have to be patient. Okay, now it is almost rebooted. As you can see, it is starting network and just power management devices, and you can check the details as well here. Okay, show details. If you will press on the show details, you can check the details as well. Just type LT. Okay, you can check the details. Okay, now we have a new window here, new screen here. Now we have to make some couple of changes here as well. So first we go for the forward option. We do not have anything. Okay, yeah, just press Alt F, and here we have to accept the agreement, license agreement. Just click forward. Here you don't need to make any changes. Click forward option again. Forward kdump. You don't need kdump, just press forward. And here we already set the time. Okay, so you don't need to, if it is wrong time, here you can set according yourself. Okay, if the date is wrong by mistake, you haven't choose in previous time, then you can choose here as well. So next to this alt f. Okay, here it is asking the I prefer to register or I like register now or let. If you have a registered cd or number, then you can register right now. But if you don't have, you have only IC file, then you can choose it later. So I'm not gonna choose it. So I'm pressing no, I prefer to register at a later time. And now press forward. You will see this screen here. I will press at the option no thanks, I'll connect later. So okay, now again click to forward option. Here it is asking for the user management. Okay, here we will not make any user, we will just manually create user from the inside. Here you just leave it blank. Okay, now alt f and continue. Okay, again it is checking your sound card. Just click forward and finish. Now all the settings related to installation has been finished, and now your system has been installed. Now you will see a new screen on your laptop or computer. Now as you can see, here is the Linux version 5, and here the default user of this system is root. So we will type root here and the password what you have given previously. Okay, earlier. So now as what I type the password and user, now you will see a different screen. Okay, this is the first screen after installation you will see on your laptop. This is the screen of Red Hat Linux. Okay, now here we have many things to do. Here just you can check the root forms, your computer settings, okay, application. But I will run it in the text mode because sometimes your cursor doesn't work, and so you can't work in the graphical mode. So if your cursor doesn't work, then you can change into in the text mode. For this you have to press alt control and f1. okay, now it will be changed into the text mode. By default you have a 6 terminal, and one is graphical mode. Okay, so 7 terminal on which you can work. So here I am typing the root, enter 1 2 3 4 5 6, that is my password. Okay, now as you can see, I am the root login user. Now let me clear this screen. Okay, now this screen is clear. Now if you will type ls, ls to list all the items on the home or home directory. Okay, if you will go to the home directory, you will see this option, and these are the folders or files that you will see on the home directory. Okay, root, that is root. Now here we can add some users, like from this command user add. Okay, user add, what's your name, you can type here. For me it's this. Okay, and enter. Now your user has been created, and you can give the password as well, then pass wd. Okay, now what, sorry, here is pass wd, not ed, pass wd. It is asking the password. I am giving here the password 1 2 3 4. Okay, enter 1 2 3 4. Sorry, password doesn't match. Again type 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, enter. Okay, your password has been updated successfully. Now if you want to check that user has been created or not, you have to exit from here. Okay, just exit. Now you have exit. If you will type beep here, and just type the password 1 2 3 4 and enter. Now you can see that you are logged from the beep user, not from the user. So this was the old installation of the Red Hat Linux. The next video we will learn some basics of the Red Hat. So thank you guys for watching my video. Keep supporting and keep loving. Thank you so much.